So we told you already about the, we previewed a little bit of this story, and it is possibly one of my favorite things because the country has to be united in hating at least somebody. And it always, I hope that it is the right people. And finally, we can all agree that Democrat and Republican, we have found the two biggest jackasses in the United States Congress. And that would be Congressman Seth Moulton. You would remember him from his failed presidential bid, and Congressman Peter Meyer. So let's put this up there on the screen. These two congressmen went to Afghanistan on a 24-hour unauthorized trip just to prance in front of the cameras and to see what was going on there. Now, here's how they did it, Crystal. They went there on a commercial flight to the UAE. Then they used their congressional experience to hop a military flight to Kabul Airport. They stayed there for a number of hours and they got on a plane and left. Now, they infuriated everyone. Why? Because diplomats and the people who were actually running the evacuation were like, hey, the last thing we need are some two low-level jackass congressmen here just screwing things up. But worse, they took up seats which could have been taken by Afghans. So they directed diplomatic and military resources away from the actual evacuation effort, put themselves on the ground, potentially in harm's way, meaning that the brass had to make sure that these two idiots were protected while they were over there. And they took away seats from the actual Afghan or American citizens. This is one of the worst displays of hubris, just so these idiots could go. And they thought they were such heroes. That's the best part of this.
Yeah.
They thought they were going to be hailed as this, oh, these amazing people came to Afghanistan. It's like everybody was like, get the hell out of here. It's like when the president knows not to come to a hurricane site 24 hours after. You know why? Because the first responders who have to protect him should be busy digging people out of rubble and making sure the people are in their homes, not having to worry about the goddamn motorcade. And yet these idiots decided to disregard all of these rules and they decided to go over to Afghanistan in the first place. It's absolutely, no matter where you even fall on this, this is one of the most outrageous acts that I've seen in a long time.
One of the most damaging and idiotic just publicity stunts that I've ever seen. They thought they were going to be big shot heroes, that everyone's going to tell them how brave they are and thank you for going. Oh, isn't this amazing? Instead, everyone was like, screw you. What are you thinking? Nancy Pelosi, Kevin McCarthy, every, you know, senior admin official that could possibly give a quote to anyone. In fact, I think we have one of the most devastating quotes here. This was from a Washington Post piece. A senior administration official said, this was as moronic as it is selfish. They're taking seats away from Americans and at-risk Afghans while putting our diplomats and service members at greater risk so they can have a moment in front of the cameras. And that is 100% accurate because look, there are terrorist threats at that airport. And you don't think that two members of Congress, a Democrat and a Republican, then those would be prime targets if you're ISIS or one of the other terror groups that has a foothold in Afghanistan? Of course, you're a prime target. So you're taking away all of these security resources just to protect your lame ass when they should be laser focused on the task at hand, which is getting out as many people as they possibly can. It was so enraging and so absurd. And as you said, the only silver lining was that it really brought everybody together in a shared spirit of screw you.
Yeah, Nancy Pelosi ripped them. That's how bad it is. Put that up there on the screen. Nancy Pelosi was like, hey, don't do it. The White House was like, we would really like to not have to worry about two idiot congressmen over in the middle of an active war zone. The Pentagon said the same thing. Frankly, they should have been denied boarding. I don't know. You know, the military, next time it's one of these idiots tries to pull something like this, tell them, no, you're not getting on this goddamn plane. You don't belong in Afghanistan. This is completely outrageous. And really what it is, you know, back to Glenn Greenwald and what he said, it is 2002 all over again. It's all just performative BS in order to try and boost their own profiles, to try and have these publicity stunts. And who suffers? Who actually suffers? The people of Afghanistan, and then our poor soldiers. Can you imagine being one of those? I would be terrified if I was the commander of Kabul. And I was like, oh, now I got to worry about these two congressmen to make sure that these guys get off this base safely. He doesn't need to be worrying about that. What if you're one of those soldiers who had to protect them or was reassigned from protecting the airport, making sure just to keep an eye on these two gentlemen? So, you know, the level of stress that this must have given our poor guys at the airport, poor, you know, guys and girls at the airport. I can't even imagine, because I've heard from some about what it's like whenever a VIP visits a war zone and they had to pull out all the stops. And that's exactly what these two guys did in this situation. They made it all about themselves. And, you know, screw you. That's all I have to say.
biggest swing and a miss that I have ever seen.
Hey guys, thanks so much for watching.
That's right. Just as a reminder, you can become a premium subscriber today. Watch the full show completely uncut. Our reactions to each other's monologues. You get to listen to it. You get to ask us questions. All that good stuff. Link is right there in the description or at breakingpoints.com.
Best of all, great way to say screw you to the mainstream media.